Hello everyone and welcome back to the Medical Awesome channel. Today's video is about the uses and half-lives of different iodine isotopes used in various thyroid diseases and scans. So we know the normal isotope is iodine-127 and it is not radioactive. The other isotopes are iodine-123, 124, 125 and iodine-131. To remember the half-lives, you can go about like iodine-123 has a half-life of 0.5 days, iodine-124 has a half-life of 5 days and iodine-125 has a half-life of 50 days. This becomes easy to remember as 0.5, 5 and 50. You increase it by 1 decimal point in each subsequent number. To remember the half-life of iodine-131, the number 3, the mirror image, can be merged with it and it becomes 8. So the half-life of iodine-131 is 8 days. So technetium-99 is also used in thyroid scans, and to remember its half-life, you just take 9 from 99, you flip it around and it becomes 6 hours. To remember the uses, thyroid-123 is used for a diagnostic purpose, thyroid-124 is used for PET scans, thyroid-125 is used for radioimmunoassays. While thyroid-127 is the normal isotope, it is non-radioactive, hence it is not used in any diagnostic test. Iodine-131 has a very long half-life and hence its use is therapeutic. Technetium-99 is also used for diagnostic purpose. And technetium-99, the test is read after 20 minutes of administration of technetium-99. While radioactive immunoassay is read after 24 hours. So you see the number 59 written besides number 50 in the half-life of iodine-125. I'll tell you why. Just to make up the mnemonic, the number 50 was chosen. But actually the half-life is 59 days. This is important because sometimes the closest option around 59 would be 60 days. So if you have such an option in an MCQ exam, don't get confused. That's it for today, guys. Let me know, was this helpful for you? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you want more such videos, I'd be happy to help. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe, and stay safe and stay awesome.